guy's inside yet. Okay, we're inside. There's one guy right there already. Just normal super mutant. If I can get a headshot off on him. Damn it. Aim for the head. Why is my AP so low? Another super mutant. Nice, got him. Okay, so something that's affecting my stats. Is it special? No. I feel like it's a bit lower though. Maybe it's my small gun proficiency. Let's loot you and you. The Wright Flyer 1. The aircraft above is right next to the sign, is the original Wright Flyer designed by Orville and Wright. Well, Wilbur Wright, on December 17th, 1903, in Kitty Hawk, North Carolina. The vehicle performed its maiden flight for a mere 12 seconds, covering a distance of only 120 feet. This historic event marked the first sustained and controlled heavier-than-air-powered flight. Nice. Okay, need to keep my eyes open here. M119 assault rifle. Well, where is it? Perhaps the most well-recognized weapon in the modern US military arsenal, the M119 earned its nickname, the Backtalker, from the unusual report of the fire missile makes it eject a spent shell. Firing standard 5.56 rounds, the M199 is still the official infantry weapon of the US Army. On loan from the International Ordnance Museum, these cases display various types of weapons and ammunition used by military in the past, conflicts over all over the globe. Okay, I'm not seeing any. X-277 Viper Magnetic Rail Cannon. This is the only known prototype of the Viper Magnetic Rail Cannon developed for the US military by Westech, so on the West Coast. Also commonly referred as a railgun. I think we get schematics of that later. The weapon, or we can get schematics of that later, the weapon uses energy cells to propel a depleted uranium round across a series of magnets, discharging it at extremely high velocity. Deemed too costly to produce on mass scale, the project was abandoned in 2044. On loan from the International Ordnance Museum, these cases display the various types of weapons and ammunition used by the military in the past conflicts all over the globe. Okie dokie. Normally I actually ignore this stuff, but yeah. Some people might find it interesting. What's this plaque over here say? 1861 Springfield Rifle Musket. The Type 1986 Springfield Rifle Musket was the standard weapon for the infantry soldier in the American Civil War. It was a muzzle-loaded weapon which fired a 58 caliber mini ball using percussion caps instead of the traditional flintlock. Almost a million of these weapons were manufactured for the soldiers during the war. On loan from the International Ordnance Museum, these cases display various types of weapons, yada yada yada. Let's go for this way. I don't need to head up there, so let's go to the right first, then to the left. Research leads terminal. The virus that has been plaguing our archetype model FF06 mainframe due to an unknown attack has finally been localized by our research team identified. After a complete cleanup on the mainframe's core, I am happy to announce that the infection has been removed. The soul of the machine has improved. Be Bell, research lead. These are in reverse order. Okay, log entry. Could someone please fix the planetarium projection system? The automated system that was just installed is prone to malfunction at least once a week. I've had to interrupt the programming more times than I care to remember and end up talking over manually. I suggest we remove the system and bring back the human elements so the audience will feel more engaged. I'd like to lodge a formal complaint regarding the firearms exhibition that's planned for temporary display in the atrium. With the world tensions the way they are right now, I feel it's highly inappropriate to glorify these killing devices by promoting them as tourist attractions. If this is some sort of patriotic gesture, then it is entirely lost upon me. I urge you to rethink this decision. A quick rundown of the acquisitions we have been awarded for 2078. If any of these interest you, please stop by and see me so we can discuss it or submit a standard research request before the cutoff date. All submissions must be made by October 2nd, 2077. Now is the time to get them in. So that's like, what, 21 days before the bombs dropped? I think it was on the 23rd of October. Supersonic airliner, Zax computer prototype, original model, T-45D power armor suit, laser pistol prototype, research lead. Our new addition to the space flight gallery, the Virgo 2 lunar lander is now open to the general public and ready for viewing. I want to extend a hearty thank you and a job well done to the entire research and restoration team for pulling that pile of junk out of mothballs and putting it in such fine shape. Many sleepless nights were spent on this project, and as a small token of our thanks, you will find a substantial bonus in your next paycheck. Give each other a pat on the back, you've earned it. Okay,
because nice. One dog ain't enough, and two is too low. It's me, Three Dog. How you kids handling post-apocalyptic today?
We interrupt our regularly scheduled program
Stealth
for
Boy.
Some news.
This is the Robco Stealth Boy Model 3001 personal stealth device developed by Robert Mayflower. The Stealth Boy generates a modulation for the transmit the reflected light from one side of an object to the other, making a bearer almost invisible to the untrained eye.
Without our buddies from the Brotherhood, I'm guessing the entire Capital Wasteland would have been overrun a long time ago. So if you see a knight or a paladin out there fighting your battles for you, give him a big thanks. Or even better, some ammo.
Check inside here.
Thanks for listening, children. This is Three Dog. Ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland. And we're here
mac and cheese. Serpentine.
Now, some
ball cap. Ruin the pencils. That's okay. It's just pencils. New cooler. Get the fire hose nozzle. Let's check out this room over here. These rooms. Toilets. Grab the darts. Why is there a dart in the bin? I have no idea. But then, with most games like this, it's like, why is that in there? In Fallout 4, you kill a legendary blood bug and it's got like a laser rifle inside it. Makes no sense. Wonder glue. I'm not going to grab the paint gun. I've got a few of them already. Goes upstairs, okay. Let's go upstairs this way. I think that's probably going to lead to the same area. Let's go to the local map. Probably leads to the same area. Yeah, it looks like it. USS Ibn Attal's flag. This flag was recovered from the wreck of the USS Ibn Attal, US Navy missile cruiser sunk off the coast of Alaska in 2066 with all hands lost. The cutting edge vessel's loss was due to a nuclear torpedo strike from the US Navy submarine. The USS's interference during the Anchorage campaign. The submarine mistook the cruiser for an enemy vessel during the radio silence and sunk it before obtaining official confirmation. This ranks as one of the worst tragic disasters in US naval history since World War II. Damn! Overlooked inventors. These portraits created the renowned contemporary artist Lincoln Mayer's depicts some of the more overlooked American inventors from top to bottom, left to right. Richard G. Drew, adhesive tape. James Whitty, cash register. Carl C. Mage, parking meter. And Mary Anderson, windshield wiper. Underlooked inventors. Nice. Halls of today. Ooh, more stealth boys. That's the same as the one before. Okay. They're quite valuable stealth boys. Halls of the day is all closed up. Okay. What have we got here? We've got Atrium Vault Tour. So where do those stairs lead then? I just want to check that quickly. Gore bag there. Camera. Grab the bottle caps. Mutilated legs aren't actually worth anything. Oh, this leads to this room. Okay. Let's read that book. Testosterone, new energy weapons increase. Nice. Let's repair some weapons while we're at it. Hunting rifle. Six % condition, 1 damage. Chinese pistol. Assault rifle. Okay. Museum maintenance. Bulletins about maintenance. The planetarium recording system has been malfunctioning, causing the map. The planetarium is on loop. After numerous complaints and a single pending lawsuit, the Giantomax Theatre's sound system has been lowered from 130 decibels to 120 decibels. Please note that all employees work in or near the theatre should still wear the proper ear protection to prevent any permanent damage. Is it that loud? So, general announcement to any employees who use the men's lavatory facility in the maintenance area. I have logged too many complaints that people are not flushing the toilets after using them. People who use the facility are to relieve themselves and expect to clean and tidy the environment. To prevent this from becoming a recurring issue, card swipe access will be required for each staff, which will log your name, time at the store, and contents of the bowl to such a time that we deem it no longer necessary. Maintenance coordinator. Jesus. Due to the increased power consumption from the installation of the Vault-Tec Vault-Tor, 3 new reactors have been installed in the sub-basement section. This should help prevent any further brownouts or full blackouts in the visitor galleries that we've been experiencing. Thanks for your patience during the transition. Okay. Don't need a sledgehammer. Turret control. I don't have enough science skill. That's a shame. Okay, let's head back upstairs then. go and do the vault tour. Yeah, that's a bit creepy, isn't it? Okay, leaving the vault tour. Museum of Technology West Wing. A pack of cigarettes, I'll grab them. Delta exhibits. What have we got down here? A couple of computers. Far out space facts. Space fact number one. The planet Jupiter is larger than 1,000 Earths. Space fact number two. The outer layers of the Sun have what's known as the differential radiation. The equator of the surface rotates once every 25.4 days, but near the poles it rotates once every 36 days. Space fact number three. A neutron star is completely dense and solid matter. In fact, it weighs a trillion times heavier than lead. That means that a piece of a neutron star the size of a pinhead would weigh as much as a large building. The Sun loses almost 4 million tons of mass every second, turning hydrogen gas into energy. That adds up to almost 345 billion tons per day. It's quite a lot. If we were to send a message to someone on a planet belonging to our closest neighbouring solar system, Alpha Centauri, which is almost 4.4 light years away, we wouldn't receive a reply message for almost 8.8 years. There are about 175 billion galaxies in the observable universe, each with as few as 10 million stars, up to giants with 1 trillion stars, all orbiting a common center of mass. Yeah, read that one already. If all the particles that make Saturn's rings were gathered together, they would form a sphere about 120 miles in diameter. Olympus Mons, a volcano found on Mars, is the largest known volcano in the solar system. It is 370 miles 595 kilometers across and rises 15 miles 24 kilometers. That's 3 times taller than Mount Everest. Okay, that's the space facts on that one. Are there different ones on these ones? For space facts, it's exactly the same ones. Okay. Anything behind here? Nope. Okay. There's nothing really here, is there? Okay, let's go up the stairs again. Wait, did I come down the stairs? That's the planetarium there. One. Got both of them. Planetarium terminal. Stop showing progress. Show stopped.
Sit back, relax, and free yourself from the bonds of our planet as
it's not stopping. I think I need to go back that way. This leads to, I don't know where. It says exit. Turn it a little bit to the right then. A bit more. Open this door. Where's this lead? Okay, that's where I need to go. Okay. So what's this way then? Hard lock. Ooh, okay. Let's get this nuclear quantum. Research leads terminal. Log entries. Yeah, I think we've read that one already. Okay. Grab the whiskey. Planetarium terminal. This was easy, so let's see. Static. One of six. Dug removed. Dug removed. Dug removed. STAT, I see. Could be letter. One of six. It's the fourth is T. ME. It can't be mental. Can't be weaken. Could be Justin. No, it can't be Justin because of the I. It can't be Remain because of the E. And there's no T. C E. No, it can't be that one. 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 Button. It could be Button. Nope. Mutter? Could be that one. Nope, okay. Anyone got allowances replenished? L-E-T-T-E-R. B-U-T-T-O-N. It could be either T. Bitten? No, because that would be two T's the same. Heated? Nope. Melted? Vector. Summon. Ah, give up. Okay, let's try that again. Mostly. Oh, there we go. Unlock planetarium exit, it's now unlocked.
Relax and free yourself from the bonds of our planet as we take off for the star.
Okay, so there's multiple ways through this. Check for the science facts. Let's go up here. Atrium. This is the other side of where we were earlier. And that's where we came in. Okay, and then we went down the stairs. Okay. Delta 9 exhibit. Anything down this way? Doesn't look like it. Ooh, got a computer here. Museum information. Exhibit guide. 09. What?
People of the capital wasteland, it is
oh, I think this is error thingy. If I click on that, you can do things in order. And you get something, but... Special events. I'm spending so much time actually reading stuff. Information.
Kids, our old friend from Vault 101 is, get this, still alive. Because there is a god.
Exhibit under construction.
Got some great news out of the town of Megaton. Turns out the live atomic bomb in the town center has finally been deep sixed for good. The town sheriff, Juan Lucas Sims, commissioned the one, the only lone wanderer from Vault 101 to disarm the nasty nuke. And the kid delivered. Hey, nice work, 101. Next time you're in the neighborhood, hop into the studio. Old Three Dogs Toaster's been on the fritz. Until next time, this is Three Dog.
There you are.
And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio.
Aim for the head.
Bring me the truth. How bad it hurts.
Now, nice. It's not about, like, getting them in order. Potion section. Yeah, I could, like... sort of lock it. The Delta 9 rocket was donated by the United States Space Administration and by grant from the United States Department of Antiquities. Cool bag. Head up here. Yeah, I seem to remember, like, in these terminals, there is a quest, like a little mini quest, and you've got to find them in order. And I completely messed that up by just like randomly clicking on things. Unfortunately, there's like a hidden message inside the computers, and you have to find the ones with the things in order, which gives you the or do you need to press the numbers in? But I completely messed it up, unfortunately. That's locked. Let's open this up. What have we got in here? I think these are the stairs I was on earlier. That's the sensor module. Have them. And I'll do here. Pork and beans. Read that plaque already. There's someone over there. I've done upstairs. Let's quickly head downstairs. This one with the hidden stuff in. No, that's not one. Grab all that. I remember there being several computers and you gotta do them in order.
Now try and hide from this.
Where are you? There you are. Okay, hello. Dead, good, good. Could do have taken a stim pack soon, maybe. Space suit. All that there. I'm getting a bit bored of reading all of them out, actually, to be honest. Some people do really enjoy that, but it grates on you after a little while. Especially when you're reading out loud. See, that's one of the hidden terminals. But I messed it up. Unfortunate. The body on there. Okay. Nuka-Cola, Voltor's this way. Oh, that's a brute. That's not good. Aim for the head. Come on. Oh crap, getting hit and I'm stuck. Aim for the head. Quick. Dodge. Need some stims. Head's been hit a bit as well. There we go. Okay. See what I can repair, because I'm getting pretty full of my inventory. Hunting rifle. That'll do. That's the dish that I need. There's another hidden terminal here. Nope. Even finding the hidden terminals is not easy. Let's grab the communications dish. Planetarium is there. That's the door that I unlocked then. Okay. And now I need to figure out how to get out of here. I have the scrap metal. Don't think I've been this way yet. Nothing in there. Suitcase, carton of cigarettes, grab that. 10-minute pistol rounds and for the custodian key for the tech museum. Is that this door here? No. Museum maintenance. That's not a hidden computer. Grab the camera. Maybe it was this one here that was locked.
I'm listening to Galaxy News Radio.
Now, how did I get out?
Your host, the Radog, Lord and Master of all, I survey. We interrupt our regularly scheduled program for some news. Here's a question for all you faithful listeners.
Well,
is
the atrium
a tree? No.
Jump down
not
here.
Shriveled black things. I'm talking real trees.
Okay, now we need to take out loads of super mutants. Door to the mall. Could sneak past.
Now what if I,
or should I take out the mutants?
Powerful three dog. Bow, wow, wow.
Yeah, time for you to go away, three dog.
Right,
he keeps repeating the same stuff over and over and over again. Actually, now keep him on. Some people like listening to him. Should I take on the mutants, or should I just sneak past? Half tempted to take them on.
I may have been experimenting with Jet at the time, but I'm telling you, it's out
there.
Thanks for listening, children.
Get into a position where I've got some cover.
When you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, we're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here.
One up there as well. Well, that's four.
Now, some music.
I can get the jump on them. I stand a chance. Nice. Got a sneak attack on him. Let's see if I can get another one.
Yeah.
Reload my gun. Aim a bit lower. Come on. Plenty of stim packs, that's okay. He's pretty far off. That guy there is shooting at me. Let's go for this guy here. Oh, he's a brute, that's not good. Aim for the head. Quick strike. Reload. Okay, need some stim packs. I could take some chems. I haven't really taken chems yet, so let's think. Stuff we know. Charisma, intelligence, strength. Rad Rich Meat, Rad Wave, Rad X. If I put a psycho, gives me more damage. Let's take one of them. Perception and intelligence. Damage resistance. Action points. 60 HP, endurance and strength. That'll do. How accurate am I going to be? Not very accurate still, but I might actually aim properly. Head crippled. Twenty-five for him. That's his normal super mutant. Wish I had a proper sniper rifle and plenty of ammo. But unfortunately, I think I've only got 2 ammo for my sniper rifle, which is back at home. Okay. A lead better. Right arm crippled, nice. Got you. I'm getting a little bit low on ammo, but not doing too bad. Oh, another one's come up. Normal super mutant, I can deal with you quite easily. Can I get that guy there? Not easy, I don't think. Start pushing up and start looting some of these bodies. Mostly clear in this area now anyway. Got him. Where's the danger? Still got a bit of ammo, and I'm gonna go pick up some more from these bodies when I get to them. Use the hunting rifle to repair my current one. That'll do. Where's the caution coming from? Why is he empty? Did the other guy loot him? Oh, I'll grab the hunting rifle, I've got a bit of space left. Start making my way to Memorial Hall. Another body there. Was there one over here which I shot? Can't recall now. What's this down here? Arsenal is over there as well, but I'm making my way to Memorial Hall at the moment. Get a Zara Brute, so if I can get a nice sneak attack on you. Head crippled. Oh. Oh god, he's got a minigun. Maybe a bit of a bit more than I can chew. Let's go back this side. How do I get up there? Over this way and that way. Okay. Whoa, God, what was that? They're firing missiles, I think. Probably a super mutant master. Or throwing grenades, maybe. Come on, come towards me. Assault rifle. Oh, my arm. Get. Grab the ant meat. And stats, stim pack. Yeah, someone's firing missiles or something somewhere. Got a minigun, level up. What are they shooting at? I can't quite make it out. Are they attacking Brotherhood or something? Ooh, Talon Company mercenaries. I remember these guys. Psycho's going off. Okay, out of ammo on that. Loot these guys. Protectron. I'll grab all that. Minigun. I'll grab the ammo. I can't really carry a minigun at the moment because I don't have much carry weight. Take that. Grenade to the face. Or to the ass. That was a good grenade. The experience. The chance is 20%. Why can't I throw a U then?
Wake up, wasteland! It's me, Freedol. Bringing all the music and news your little hearts can handle.
I'm killed by someone else.
Yes, time for the news.
Okay, taking a bit of damage
good
this way.
News, kids. Our old friend from Vault 101 is, get this, still alive.
Let's head to
there
Memorial.
Here's your update on the Ranger of the Wastes. Got some great news out of the town of Megaton. Turns out the live atomic bomb in the town center has finally been deep-sixed for good.
Check my weapons.
One Lucas Sims,
items, weapons.
The one, the only lone wanderer from Vault 101 to disarm the nasty.
That one's there.
And the kid delivered. Hey, nice.
Need
work
more carry weight.
Next time you're in the neighborhood, pop into the studio. Old Three Dogs Toaster's been on the fritz. Thanks for listening,
howdy.
Children. This is $3.
No ammo for my assault rifle. Plenty of shotgun rounds, eh?
Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here.
With some stim packs. Almost forgot about that.
Listen close for this important public service announcement. Remember, children, when the raiders come, there ain't no shame in locking your doors, barricading the windows, and cowering under the nearest bed. When these psychos come to play, they have one thing on their minds: making your life as fucking miserable as humanly possible.
Spotted me, I think.
Raiders can't be bargained or reasoned with.
Sneak attack, critical on him. Nice. What did he have on him? Ooh, level up now. Nice. Lockpicks at 50, repairs at 50. I think I'm going to invest all 22 into small guns. Because then that'll increase my effectiveness, which I think reduces my VATS cost as well. And increases my accuracy. It's continue. Scrounger, more ammunition in containers. That is not a bad one to get, actually. But I'm not too bad for ammo at the moment. Commando. While using a rifle, considerable accuracy boost in VATS. It's not bad. With the impartial meditation perk, you gain extra 30 points to speech, so long as you're maintaining a neutral karma level. That's not easy to do as it is, so no. Intense training? Yeah, why not? Let's just get intense training done. I'm gonna boost my luck. I could do. No, endurance. I'm gonna get that up to 5 as well. Where's this guy's body, which I just shot? There he is. Prepare my assault rifle. That one. Where's the caution? Someone must have spotted me somewhere. Danger? Oh, hello. You're close. Come on, hit him in the head at least once. Oh, come on. Get some grenades going. 72% chance, not bad at all. What, 72% chance? And you just messed it up. Okay. Try that. Oh, come on. Works best when they're out in the open. He's got a minigun. Come on. No, I might get his mate though. No, his mate's rushed up forwards. Damn it. Run, 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 run. Lob grenades. Nice. Leg crippled. Ooh, both of their left legs were crippled. Where are you, normal super mutant? Ha, you got blown up. And lost a leg, I think. Assault rifle. And got you. Very nice. Okay. What's my weight at now? I can grab the minigun. Nice, I'll do that then. And grab the ammo from you. Grab the hunting rifle rounds. What's this here? That is hunting rifle. Not fussed about that. Who are you? Brotherhood is still initiate. I'll grab your holo tag. I think that's all of them dealt with now. There's one or two hidden in this trench here. I think that's them. Yeah, we're getting the level up, so it's not too bad. A bit low on ammo on that, though. Still got plenty of rifle rounds, though. Scavenger perk will be handy, though. Discovered the Washington Monument. Let's open the gate. Open the outer security door. Nothing in there. Nothing in there. Let's go to the Washington Monument. Anything over here? Nope. Let's press the button. And up we go. Look out the broken window. Well, it shouldn't actually be a window there, but it's broken. On our way up. You can't actually see anything outside at all. It's kind of odd. Why can't I see anything? Millimeter rounds, very nice. Metal helmets. Let's have a look, see if it's any good. Nope. Galaxy News Radio Relay. Install the Virgo dish and activate the relay. Speak to Three Dog about Dad. Okay, so there's the White House, I suppose. And this is probably the lawn that's in front of the White House. Possibly. I don't really know that much about America. I've seen it in a few films. Can I not jump out here? Doesn't look like it. Okay, I'm going to see if I can fast travel just to save a bit of time. Well, save a lot of time, actually. GNR Building Plaza. Okay.
Beloved Capital Wasteland, you can hear me!
Yes, I can.
You can't stop that signal, baby. That's right. From Megaton to Gertershade, Paradise Falls to the Republic of Dave, we're coming to you loud and proud. In a special live report. But Three Dog, you're in that cool radio studio in D.C. How do
this
you
isn't
know
free dog.
I can hear you all the way out here in the ass end of nowhere? Because of the kid from Vault 101, that's how. That cat actually managed to repair our antenna relay. How's that for ingenuity, folks? From here on in, it's bye-bye, stupid static. Hello, magnificent music. So sit back, relax, and absorb these classic tunes. Thanks for listening, children. This is Three Dog, ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you.
He's not even live.
Music. Smooth move.
It's a recording, it's not even live. Anyway, sort of Free Dog.
Hey, alright! The hero of the wasteland returns.
Thanks, Free Dog. I was glad to help with the good fight.
Hey, you're the one that deserves all the thanks. You struck a major blow against tyranny. Now, GNR can be heard clear across the Capital Wasteland again. That'll give Eden and those muties something to think about. Before I get back to my calling, I bet you want to hear about your dad.
Well, yeah, where's my dad gone?
When your dad passed through here, he and I talked for a good long time. He's a real stand-up kind of guy. He mentioned some scientific mumbo-jumbo, which didn't make sense to me. And mentioned something called Project Purity. He also said something about going to visit a Dr. Lee in Rivet City. Then he left in a hurry.
Rivet City, where is that?
You never heard of Rivet City? Wow. Just, wow. Well, a whole bunch of people got together and turned a beached aircraft carrier into a town. Pretty cool, huh? Just follow the river south from here. There's no way you can miss it.
How are things now? The power's back. 400 experience, eh. Not much towards leveling up.
Can't even tell you the love I'm getting from the wasteland. Ever since GNR started singing again, the guys downstairs told me that more people than ever are tuning in.
It's all I ever wanted.
I have to go now.
Anytime you need a place to crash, duck in here. Be glad to provide.
Okay. Well, we're going to head back to Megaton. What time is it? It's still quite early, yeah? I'm just absolutely boiling because of this heat. Can't travel in here to jump down yet. And go to Megaton. There it is, fast travel there. And let's go to my house and drop off loads and loads of stuff.
wounded, sir. May I suggest you seek medical attention as soon as possible?
That'll be alright. Okay, so. Drop off one of my assault rifles. Don't want the minigun. Keep the sort of shotgun. Get rid of the switchblade. Drop off all the ant meats, the beer, all the food. Blood packs. Dirty water. Guana bits. Nuka Cola. Quantum. I want to wait until I get the fridge for the Nuka Cola and then I can make it better. Dropping beans, purified water. I keep one of them just to get my health back a bit. Rad roach meat, scotch. Let's put two stealth boys in there. All the whiskey, and then all the misc stuff. Cameras, carton of cigarettes, tray bomb, conductors, empty whiskey bottle. Okay. Food sanitizer. No, I want to keep the food sanitizer. Food sanitizer. Glass pitcher. Don't know why I picked that up. Cigarettes. Keep the pre-war money because it's got no weight to it. Sensor modules. Serpentine, wonder glue. Actually, how much scrap metal have I actually got now? Scrap metal 14. Actually, I'm going to hand all that into the guy upstairs above the criticized supply. Hand this into the purifier guy and get some money. Oh, I could do it for no charge and gain more karma. What's my karma at the moment? Good protector.
You have? Yeah, what is it?
Want some scrap metal?
I sure am, sonny. What have you got for me?
Take all the scrap metal I have.
Well, all right. Let me count out your caps.
I have to go now. How many caps have I got? Items, caps, 974. That's not bad, actually. I think I can afford a workbench now. Criticized supply.
How are those hot little potatoes? Because, you know, they're on the ground. Like potatoes. And hot because they, explode. Anyway, what's up?
I'm not gonna lie to her. What do you know about Minefield?
They say it was a town called Ridgefield, until slavers cleared it out. Now, it's supposedly cursed and just a death trap to visitors. Now, everyone calls the place Minefield and says it's a ghost town. Superstitious nonsense, of course, but that's how people think. You'll be fine.
I hear the other person. That's good to... Let me see what you have for sale.
Absolutely.
Let's see. House, get a new color machine, but I want the workbench. I've already got the schematic from her. Yep, okay. Fusion battery. Let's recharge packs. Grab some ammo. That will do. Accept that. And exit.
Good hunting.
I have to go now.
Remember, I'll buy whatever you're selling.
Okay, let's go grab all my junk and see if I can make a rocket launcher. I think it's called the rocket launcher in this.
I hope things are going well with you today, sir.
Okay, let's grab all the misc. Grab all this stuff. Exit there, go to the workbench, rocket launcher. And what quality is this at? Weapons, rocket launcher, let's make another one. And then we'll repair the rocket launcher. Make one more, I think. Repair that with this one. And that's pretty much as high repair as it can get. I can do one more. Repair this. Getting four more condition. Okay. Weapons, rocket launcher, because I don't have big guns at the moment. And what do I want to keep? Conductors, I'll keep. Crutch, I'll keep. Fire hose nozzle, I'll keep. Fission batteries. Lawnmower blade, I'll keep. Leaf blowers. Leather belts, I think. Motorcycle gas tank. Handbrakes. Paint gun? I'm not sure. Now I'll keep them. I'll keep half of them. James left Vault 101 without telling the kid why. Pilot lights, I'll keep half of them. Pressure cookers, I'll keep them.
Looks that way. So who knows? Maybe James is going
sensor
to
modules, I'll keep five of them. They're quite common.
But James,
keep the sheet music book. Steam gauge assembly. Vacuum cleaner, and I keep five Wonder Glue. Exit that, and I'm gonna take everything over to Crater Side Supply.
I wish there were more people like you in the world. I want you to have this.
Thank you.
Bless you.
I'm over-encumbered and cannot run, I know. Screw it on a stick. I'll eat that. Come on, let's go to Crater Side Supply, sell all this crap, and hopefully there's a trader outside as well I can sell to. Go to the Brass Lantern as well, and the clinic, and might be a trader outside. But Crater Side Supply first, because she's got the most money in town. It's just a bit of a struggle. How much do I weigh at the moment? Not too much over, actually.
Hello?
Hello. Let's just scroll out of it. We'll find a better hat at some point. In we go. Talk to
how
you.
Are those hot little potatoes?
It's what you got for sale. I haven't been to Minefield yet. Hold on.
It's not just because.
What you got for sale? Got plenty of money. So let's go to Misk. You can have the Abraxa cleaner. All of them. Box of detergent. Cameras. All of them. Carton of cigarettes. All of them. Tray bombs. Actually, I need to keep them. Empty whiskey bottle. Glass pitcher. Harmonica. Lunchbox. Medical brace. Pack of cigarettes. All of them. Pilot lights. Paint guns. All the pre-war money. Rad scorpion. Poison gland. Rake. Sensor module. Let's just sell the other stuff, actually. Wonder glue. Turpentine. Surgical tubing. Let's try half of the sensor modules. That'll do. And exit.
Good hunting.
I have to go now.
Good.
I can still run around now. How many caps have I got? Nice. 1, 2, 3, 5. Nice amount of caps there. Okay, I wonder if there's a trader outside. Might have schematics or something. Quite often the traders that come here have got schematics. Okay, no traders, but I've got plenty of inventory space left. Where should I head next? Actually, let's check on the map. Quests. We've got Blood Ties, Deliver Lucy's Message, Wasteland Survival Guide. Those, Find a Home for Brian Wilkes, and Scientific Pursuits, Gain Entrance to Rivet City. Now that could be good, because then I can get the Intelligence Bobblehead. I think I might do that, actually. So if I go to the Museum of Technology, the Capitol Building. If I go to the Museum of Technology, see what the best route is, follow that route, go to Rivet City, head down to the lab, get the intelligence bobblehead. When I next level up, I'll get an extra point. Yeah, I think I'll do that. So, Museum of Technology, just head here. What's my quest at the moment? Yeah, Scientific Pursuit. Okay, so we need to head down. We need to head this way. Let's check the local map. I have not been down this way yet, so I think this is the way I need to go. Keep an eye out for traps, mines. Turn the light on as well, it makes it a little bit easier to see. Hello, reader. Oh, critical strike, nice. Okay, so there's a good chance more raiders up ahead, so we need to be cautious. Well, I'll grab the Chinese pistol, why not? I can always sell it later. Got the hiccups now, which isn't good. Just gotta keep a purified water to get my health back up as well. I did. There we go. Door to and Costia Crossing Station. Let's go right. What's to the left? Dead end. Okay. Let's keep sneaking along here. These guys to the right here.
And here's me.
Crap, missed. Headshot. Head crippled.
Pop in and see what it's like.
Reload.
Thanks for listening, children. This
say, experience not bad.
When you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, we're Radio
not too bad value for money. 10 times worth the weight,
now
so yeah, I got that.
This important public service announcement. Listen, kiddos, never forget the importance of periodic weapon maintenance.
Let's search this area quickly.
Pistol, police baton, I don't care which. If your weapon is falling apart, the only wasteland asshole it's gonna kill is you.
Skin pack.
So be smart.
Tin can.
Salvage
nope.
Those parts and make repairs whenever you can. And now, some music.
They've got no ammo stash around here. That's a bit rare when there's raiders. When there's an ammo stash about. Okay, let's carry on sneaking along here. Keeping out for mines and traps. If we go over here, then this is like a. No, I can't get through that way. Okay. There's someone around here. Must be upstairs. There's one. Turn my light off. I don't know if that actually affects my stealth rating. There is a raider above me, and there's a raider up there as well. There's two here, one right above up there. Okay, I'm going to go up this way, I think. I personally would put a trap on one of these stairways. You. You. That's two down. Okay. Crutch. I'll grab that. What's that there? Radex. Squirrel Stew. Pilgrim Illustrated. Let's read you. And armed up again. Not that I ever actually really use it. Paint gun. Grab that. Mentance. Buff out. Cup of beer. Coca-Cola. Grab all that. Weapons. Think assault rifle can't be repaired. Hunting rifle can be repaired for 2% condition. Okay, I'm going along this way. Someone over here somewhere. There you are. Took your head off. What have we got in here then? First aid box. 10mm pistol and some ammo. Buff out. Ooh, combat shotgun. Nice. Waiting for that. Weapons. That's going to take over. Slot 2, assault rifle number 3. That's right, yep. Okay, so local map. Need to head this way. Okay, there are still enemies over here though. Should I take them out? Yeah, why not? Some Nuka-Cola. Okay, there's a path down here, but it's blocked by trains. Path here as well. Okay. There you are. Okay. Give me a shot. Taking out you. Take the frag grenade. Okay, I'm not going that way because I'm heading to Rivet City now. I can explore the sewer system later. More new cooler, check the toilets quickly. Stuff in the box, I'll grab all this. Come on, pick you up. Anything in here? Ooh, that's completely blocked off. Dark nuclear and wonder glue though. Right, who's going to be outside this way? And of course you're crossing. Is there a trader over here? Oh, at River City, nice. That didn't take too long. I thought it was going to take a bit longer than that. But there's someone friendly around here. Hang on. That's Talon Company mercenaries. This is not good. This is not good. Hello.
Well now, if it isn't the little saint from the vault. We've been looking for you. Someone's put quite a price on your head. What? You think you can walk around the wasteland doing the things that you do, and there isn't going to be someone who takes notice? Such a shame. I hear that you could have been something useful. Ah, well. Time to die.
I'm not gonna say can't we talk to that. Well, what are you waiting for?
Ha! I love it when they go down fighting.
Aim for your head. Okay, that's not good. I was just hoping to do a little better than that. Reload. Get some frag grenades going. Frag grenade out! Come on. Nice, leg crippled. Get in the cover. Got some AP left. Okay, fire at you. Good grenade. Right leg crippled. And left leg. Right arm as well. Chuck a grenade at you. And I can repair my combat shotgun using yours as well. Get my assault rifle. Oh god. That blew up. Ah, man, they're on the last bullet. Combat shotgun, laser rifle, Buckingham Cell, Private Contract, Kill Jimbo, Talon Combat Armor.
One of these wackos seems to be assisted by robots, and the other by mutated.
Grab all the bits and pieces.
Every day it seems to be the same nutty scene with the scuffles ending in a stalemate.
Items, okay.
So if your travels take you to Canterbury
Can't
Commons,
repair that one.
Keep your head down.
I can repair that one.
Rifle loaded for crazy.
Combat shotgun, repair. And assault rifle, prepare that. There we go. Check the data. Notes, Virgo Lunar Launcher. Access.
You see, children, the Frankensteins might violently and horrifically.
Renfield is a new password, okay. Photo of Dr. Lee.
According to most of our reports on the super mutants,
and contract to kill Jimbo.
Hauling them off to God knows where.
Boys and girls, we've got ourselves another holier than thou white knight needs putting down. Here are the details: name Jimbo Spike, race Caucasian, sex male. Bounty is 1,000 caps this time around, and for a change of pace, they want the head this time. Good hunting. Okay. I'm a very good protector. Very nice. Okay, so these guys are hostile to me, and I need to take some Simpax. There we go. Good health again. We're gonna wait.
Please, can you help me? I need water. Purified water, please.
All I have is irradiated water.
I've been drinking whatever I can find, but I can't do it anymore. I need purified water. Please. If you find any.
Yeah, I don't have any on me at the moment.
Welcome to Rivet City. Please wait while the bridge extends.
Thank you. Well, I'm not going to wander off, am I? I came all this way.
Hold it right there. State your business in Rivet City.
Why didn't you ask me that while I was on the other side? I'm looking for my father.
And who might your father be? If he lives on this boat, I know him.
He doesn't live here. He came to see Dr. Lee. Well, I could say I'm sure you don't know him. He's lived in a vault his entire life.
Oh yeah? And I'm a fairy princess. You keep up this smart-ass attitude, and you're gonna wind up floating face down in the river.
He doesn't live here. He came here to see Dr. Lee.
Dr. Lee, eh? Well, then I guess you'd have to ask Dr. Lee for more information. Go on up then. She's probably in the science lab. But keep your nose clean. You hear me?
I'm kind of lost. Can you help me?
I suppose.
Where is Dr. Lee's lab?
The door on the left goes to the stairwell. From there, just keep heading west.
Why do you decide to live in this rusty old tub?
We're the safest, most secure city in the wasteland. Nothing can get in here without our say-so.
Thanks for the help.
Carry on, then.
Hello, security.
I'm on duty. Make it quick.
I have to go now.
Yeah.
Door on the left.
Good to see you.
And head west. Science lab this way. More security. Science lab is left. Into the science lab. And if I quickly go down here, it's somewhere around here, isn't it? There it is. Intelligence bobblehead. You found a Vault-Tec limited edition bobblehead. The inscription on the base reads, it takes the smartest individuals to realize there's always more to learn. Your intelligence will be permanently increased by one. Now it's level 10, very nice. Hello, Dr. Preston.
You don't look hurt. What can I do for you?
This place looks pretty easy to rob. You have any problems with thieves?
Don't get any cute ideas. Security is just a shout away. Now, if you've got any medical issues, let's hear them.
I could use some help.
I don't see anything wrong with you.
Okay, bye, Doc.
Take care of yourself.
Dr. Lee.
Look, this is a restricted area. I'm tired of telling you people. It's you. My heavens, you look so much like him. You're James's son, aren't you? What are you doing here?
Wait, how do you know who I am? Have we met?
You were too young to remember, and I suppose James never spoke of me. Typical. I'm Dr. Madison Lee. I worked with your parents many years ago. Now I run the science lab here in Rivet City. It was all I had left. When your mother died, your father decided to leave with you. He abandoned our work. We had no choice but to do the same.
I'm trying to find my father. Have you seen him?
You mean you haven't? I assumed he sent you here. For that matter, aren't you supposed to be in a vault? James said he left you there.
I left the vault to look for him.
Did you? I was under the impression that's exactly the opposite of what he wanted for you. Well, you won't find him here. He's come and gone already.
I'm sorry, could you please tell me where he's gone?
Your father insisted that we return to work on Project Purity. I tried telling him too much time has passed. There's no way it would work. Predictably, he refused to listen to me. He says he can prove it will work and headed off to the old lab. I'm sorry, I don't know what else to tell you.
Where is this old lab of yours?
It's in the old Jefferson Memorial Building, northwest of here. Please, don't go after him. It was foolish of him to even think about going there alone.
Map marker added. Look for Dad in Project Purity's control room. Can you remind me where my father went?
The last I knew, he was headed back to the lab at Project Purity in the old Jefferson Memorial Building. I still say it's dangerous, and he shouldn't have risked it. That's all I know.
Oh, a bit tired, actually. Can you tell me more about my parents?
I suppose so. I worked with them for several years until... until your mother died, and your father decided it was time to leave. What else do you want to know?
What was my father like back then?
James? He was very driven, determined to change the world. Well, we all were back then, I suppose. He was focused on two things, really. Making Project Purity work, and your mother. When she died, I think he gave up. I know he wanted to keep you safe, but I think part of what he did was run away. But it seems that he never really was able to get over the idea. I'm frankly shocked that he waited all this time and wants to try again.
I never knew my mother. Can you tell me about her?
Yes. Your mother was... well, she was a good woman. A very dedicated scientist. Your father loved her very much. It was a shame that she died. She had been excited to meet you.
Why did my mother die? What happened?
Complications from childbirth. None of us were expecting it. We weren't as prepared as we could have been. You have to understand... we were struggling with scavenged, derelict equipment. We did everything we could.
I understand. I'm sure you did everything you could.
Yes. Well, I'm sorry it wasn't enough.
Let's talk about something else.
Okay.
Can you tell me more about my parents?
What do you want to know?
Okay. I don't know why that's... lit up. Is there any way you can help me out?
Look, I don't want to be harsh, but I have problems of my own. I don't have the resources to support James's foolish endeavors or your chasing after him. I'm sorry.
Come on, isn't there anything you can do to help?
I suppose I can spare a few stim packs. It's not much, but it might make things easier for you.
I'd like to know a bit more about you.
What? Well, I'm not sure what there is to tell. Your father and I, we worked together for a long time. I think we were really on to something. But then there were complications. The project was abandoned and your father disappeared. I returned here to Rivet City and established the lab you see before you now.
Tell me about this project you worked on with my father.
Project Purity, we called it. What do you want to know?
What was the point of it?
It was simple, really. Fresh, clean water for everyone. Such a simple idea, and yet so impossible to realize. The plan was to build a facility that could purify all the water in the tidal basin at once. No radiation, no muck, just clear water. It just turned out to be more difficult than we anticipated.
Why didn't it work?
We had the basic principles down. We understood most of the science behind it, but the radiation in the area is so pervasive. Small-scale tests were fine. But any time we tried to test the process on a larger scale, it was just too much. Maybe if we'd had more time or better equipment.
Why did you stop working on it? What happened?
You happened. It wasn't just you. We had more problems than we could handle already, but your birth is what finally pushed it over the edge. Your father decided that you were more important than everything we'd been working for, and he left. He left all of us. Once he was gone, the Brotherhood decided we weren't worth their time anymore. Without their protection, we had to abandon the purifier.
Let's talk about something else.
Oh.
What is this lab? What are you doing here?
This is the Rivet City Science Lab. It's taken many long years to put together, but we've done well for ourselves. Our work on portable fusion power and hydroponics are coming along quite nicely, if not quite according to schedule.
What kind of place is this Rivet City?
Rivet City is one of the few bastions of civilization left in the land. We're working to rebuild our society, to make the world livable again.
I have to go now.
Good luck finding your father.
Brad is dedicated to solving real problems.
Yes, yes, yes. But Dr. Lee...
Dr. Lee is trying to save lives, and your constant interruptions are interfering with those efforts. Now please, stand aside.
I'm sure the good doctor's work with water purification is fascinating, but if you only knew what was at stake, the technology in that android...
What's at stake? You won't tell me what's at stake. Vagaries and secrecy. A robot, Zimmer, no matter how shiny the paint job. Now, please.
Ignorance and facetiousness. That's all you people are good for. Shiny paint job, indeed. You can't even imagine the Commonwealth's accomplishments.
You know, if you're so smart, maybe you could help us, hmm? But no, that never even crossed your mind. Go peddle your selfishness somewhere else.
Fine. But I'm not leaving. Not until I've spoken to Dr. Lee. I'll be here when she's ready to abandon her chemistry set and talk real science.
Suit yourself. Yeah?
I'm looking for my father. Have you seen him?
Look, some of us are trying to get work done here. There have been enough disruptions recently. Anybody coming through here would have to talk to Dr. Lee. Why don't you go bother her about it?
What do you have? Is Dr. Lee as smart as they say she is?
She's certainly head and shoulders above most everyone else around here. Though, that's not saying much.
Can I get a drink around here, preferably somewhere clean?
The Weatherly Hotel is a good choice. It's on the upper deck.
See you later.
Bye.
You there. What are you, some kind of lab assistant? No, you look a bit more weathered. Are you by any chance for hire?
You have a problem with the way I look?
How amusing. You've mistaken my metaphor for a derogatory remark. I need a local, you see. Someone with verve. I've misplaced some very sensitive property.
Missing property? What kind of property?
How do I put this in a way you'll understand? All you know of robots are those buckets of bolts, those Mr. Handshakers and whatnot. Well, that's not all a robot can be. You see, in the Commonwealth, we've made artificial persons, synthetic humanoids, programmed to think and feel and do whatever we need. And occasionally, they get confused and wander off.
Sounds like slavery to me. You sure they didn't wander off on purpose?
Nonsense! This is a machine we're talking about. Can you enslave a generator or a water purifier? Of course not. The same principle applies. But let's get back to your mission. You are to find this missing android. I've tracked him to somewhere here in the capital wasteland. He must have done something drastic, like facial surgery and a mind wipe, or else I would have found him by now. It will be no easy task. He may not even realize he's an android. Don't upset him by talking with him. Just come get me immediately. I'll handle it.
I'm not sure how it is up north, but around here we get paid for our work.
I'm sorry, it slipped my mind. I have at my disposal advanced technology from the Commonwealth. I'd be willing to share some of it with you. Just think, you'll be the envy of all your friends.
Sure, I'll look into finding an android for you.
Excellent! Locate my android and you won't be disappointed. Here, listen to this message he sent me. He's mocking me. I swear, I'll make him pay for that.
I need to know more about what I'm dealing with. What is an android exactly?
Forget everything you know about robots. Those buckets are mere children's toys compared to the real thing. Androids have fake skin and blood and are programmed to simulate human behavior, like breathing. They can even eat and digest food realistically.
So, any suggestions for finding this android?
Like I said, I suspect he's had facial reconstruction and possibly even a mind wipe. Search the offices of doctors or techies for android information. If he's come into contact with these people, there may be records. Start with Dr. Preston. He lives on this leaky boat. See if he knows anything. He's a doctor, after all. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm busy trying to ignore my surroundings.
If this android wandered off, why would he want a new mind and face?
Maybe he didn't exactly wander off. Maybe he fled. Escaped captivity, as it were, if he began to misinterpret his situation. It's possible my android sought to forget his previous life. Wipe away all memory, all guilt. Trick himself into believing he really is human. So no, he may not be just an ordinary robot, but he's certainly not human, no matter how badly he wishes it so. I made him, I want him. End of story.
Why would an android feel guilty? Come on, Zimmer, what aren't you telling me?
By God, you're as annoying as you are clever. Very well. I'll tell you what you want to know, if it helps you locate my property. The duty of this particular unit was the hunting and capturing of other escaped androids. Yes, others have escaped. It's one of the side effects of having such an advanced AI. Machines start to think for themselves, fool themselves into believing they have rights. And so, this particular android may have believed he'd done something wrong, immoral, and wanted to forget those deeds. Satisfied now?
Okay, so if others have escaped, why are you coming after this one?
This particular android, designation A321, is different. Special. The most advanced synthetic humanoid I've ever developed. The others, like my escort Armitage there, are all older models, easily replicated. Ah, but A321? It will take years to recreate him. So you see, this android must be located at all costs. The others are all acceptable losses, but A321, he is irreplaceable.
So tell me about the Commonwealth.
The Commonwealth itself is nothing but a war-ravaged quagmire of violence and despair. Inside the sealed environment of the Institute, however. But The Institute's affairs are none of your concern. Your undeveloped mind couldn't even begin to comprehend what we've accomplished.
I have to go now.
Of course you do.
I mean, that is quite interesting, actually. I've played a fair amount of Fallout 4, and the fact that they've got this quest in Fallout 3 says to me they were planning Fallout 4 at some point during the production of Fallout 3. No, what's his name? Todd Howard or something like that. Howard Todd. Todd Howard. One of those names. Did mention in the Fallout 4 reveal how they started working on it straight after Fallout 3, but from this, makes me think that they were thinking about it before then, during the production of Fallout 3. I mean, this might have just been a quest they slapped in right at the end, but then again, it could have been one they put in quite early on. Let's talk to you.
What do you need?
What do you know about Zimmer?
He's from up north. He was bragging about how great it is up there. Yeah, great. They can't even keep tabs on their robots.
He was just calling it a war-torn state a minute ago, and then he was saying it's all great. And it's like, what? Let's speak to you. Armitage.
Lay a hand on Dr. Zimmer and I'll snap your neck like a chicken bone.
Okay. Look for records in sciencey places and techie places. Okay, where's everyone else gone? I have no idea. The thing is, I'm actually quite tired, so I think I'm going to call that it for tonight. I haven't actually done that much tonight. I've made it to Rivet City. I did the Museum of Technology. I did Galaxy News Radio, but that's about it. I discovered the Capitol building, but didn't actually go there. I went to the Washington Monument, fixed up Galaxy News Radio. We haven't done that much tonight. I've only been going about, 3 hours? 3 hours and 18 minutes, actually. But yeah, I'm actually pretty tired already. So I'm actually going to call it a night here. Unfortunately, you know, it can't really be helped. I'm tired. My mind is, drifting a bit. I'll probably start a bit earlier tomorrow, I think. But yeah, that's it for tonight, guys. I hope you enjoyed, and hope to see you guys tomorrow. I'll save that, and good night for now. Goodbye, everybody.